first is the introduction. Agro-based industries are those which depend upon agriculture for their raw material. India ranked first in good khansari industry. The good khansari, popularly known as Khulwadi in Punjab, are set up mainly for the production of wood and shakkar. This industry includes various activities like extraction of sugarcane juice, boiling of juice, clarifying the boiling juice with the help of sieve by adding immersion like solution in the juice, then to convert it into hard substance called wood. The base product was used as a fuel for wood making. Next is objective. The first objective was to highlight the socio-economic profile of entrepreneurs who were engaged in wood khansari agro-processing village industry in Punjab. And the next is to work out the economics of wood khansari industry. And then the methodology. In order to achieve the objective, the study was conducted in Punjab through the collection of primary data. Multi-stage sampling technique was adopted for the research. Central zone having highest number of small-scale units was selected in the first stage. Then the Fatehgarh Sahib district falling in the central zone was randomly taken in the second stage. From 444 villages falling under the district, 40 villages were randomly taken for the study in the third stage. Each village was visited personally. In all villages, total 15 agro-based food khansari industries are found. The information was collected from the entrepreneurs engaged in these agro-based village industries taken under study by personal interview method. That is socio-economic profile of good khansari entrepreneurs, in which the study found that all entrepreneurs were male and there were no female entrepreneur was found because of the stereotype nature of rural society. And majority of the entrepreneurs were comes under the age group of 46 to 55 years. And most of the entrepreneurs are educated, were educated up to middle, and they have no technical knowledge about their enterprise. And most of the entrepreneurs were belong to Sikh religion and Chodal caste. And there was no large farmer was found under the study, and the number of landless entrepreneurs were only three. Next is most of the entrepreneurs are lived in nuclear family, and the average number of family members were 3 to 4 members. And there is no entrepreneur were taking loan for their enterprise. They were all taking khansari enterprise, in which the capital investment was highest in case of small entrepreneurs which have small farms. And also the fixed cost is also highest in case of entrepreneurs which have small farms. Next is the total variable cost is also highest in case of small entrepreneurs. Next is returns and cost incurred on all farms categories of good khansari entrepreneurs, in which the landless entrepreneurs have highest gross returns, whereas fixed cost is highest in case of entrepreneurs which have small farms, and in case of variable cost and total cost was highest for landless entrepreneurs. Whereas the return over variable cost and return over total cost was highest for entrepreneurs which have semi-medium farms. Next is economic evaluation of good khansari enterprise, in which the actual quantity of sugarcane crushed for the survival of enterprise was 10,922 quintals, whereas break-even quantity was 6,323 quintals. And the quantity above break-even quantity was 2,791. It means that the actual quantity was more than the required for the survival of the enterprise. Whereas the payback period to recoup the funds expended to an investment was 2 years. Next is input-output relationship for good khansari enterprise. It means by investing 1 rupees on fixed and variable resources, an amount of 1.27 rupees on an average indicated as output capital ratio. Whereas benefit cost ratio at variable cost was 0.27 and benefit cost ratio at total cost was 0.18. Next is conclusion. The study revealed that entrepreneurs who had semi-medium farms had highest annual net returns. The payback period of good khansari enterprise were 2.13 years of investment of the enterprise. Good quantity enterprise is an enterprise which made profit in long run. The average break-even quantity was estimated to be 6,812 kg per annum of sugarcane crush to make good was more than the quantity which was required for the survival of good Khansari enterprise. Benefit cost ratio over variable was 0.27, benefit cost ratio over total cost was 0.18. On average, the share of fixed cost in output capital ratio was lower as compared to the share of variable cost in good Khansari enterprise.
Any questions? Any interaction, any question, any comment? Payment period is much lower in case of marginal farming as compared to medium or 7 million farmers. What are you doing? Payback period 1.5 in the marginal farmer? No, sir,
1.39.
1.39,
yes.
That's the landless, I think.
No, sir, for landless is 1.5.
1.5, the marginal 1.31.
Okay.
And for the large farmer?
Sir, there is no large
farmer. What category large farmer?
Medium.
Medium, how much?
2.85.
So, how much is the distance? I just want to payback period in case of marginal farmer is 1.31. And in case of larger farmer, larger, not large farmer, it is 2.1. What does it mean? But it shows that which one is more efficient and why?
See, because the large farmer take more for their agriculture purpose also. So that's why they take more time to give it.
Payback period thoda hoga, double payback period.
Sir, payback period means ki apan ki nahi chalti, apan jodi investment, you know, pop up kar diye.
Jitna payback period cut hai, more efficient chalega. That means you want to say marginal farmer, they are much more.
Because sir, unna jada AS candy, is candy for
whatever. So this is a independent business. They are taking a loan for this, they are making business out of it. So payback is so when you do the project evaluation, so how much money we have invested and how much income we are earning. So 1.31 is that 1.31 year is required to pay back everything. So whatever they from they are taking a loan. So that means marginal farmers, they are much more efficient as compared to this. So what do you want to suggest out of it? And how you relate to that sustainable agriculture?
Sir, it is an enterprise besides agriculture from where we can earn our livelihood. And it is in long run, it is a very stable enterprise from where we can earn a lot of
stuff. You want to say that marginal or small farmers should take up the inactivity because they are much more efficient as compared to medium and large farmers?
Because sir, they also have their own land to
Any observation, any question? If there is no time, invite for the next speaker.
Thank you.